Hey, guys, it's Mrs. Miller coming to you again with another Google Slide production. Today, we're going to talk about Japan's population density. So first, I think we need to review the definition of population density. So what is population density? Population density of a country or a city is a way of showing how crowded that place is. It is calculated by dividing the population by the total area. So think about the population density of our hallways at Elkhart Central High School. Just how crowded they can be when students are in hallways trying to hurry to class. So think about that. Population density calculated by dividing the population by the total area. So Japan's current population is about 126 million people. And that's a lot of people. It's not as large as the United States. But Japan's landmass is roughly the size of California. California is our largest state, has a population about 38.5 million people. So Japan has almost 80 million more people living on the same size land as California. Tokyo, Japan, which is actually the capital city of Japan, is the largest and most densely populated area on Earth. This is actually a GIF of one of the intersections, major intersections in Tokyo, and it is extremely crowded on a regular basis, and look at all those people crossing the street. Can you imagine doing that? So how does Japan's high population density affect transportation? The average employee in Tokyo commutes, basically travels, 90 minutes to work every day. And think about that, 90 minutes of your day is just spent traveling to work. And because of this, crowding and the large commute times has led to some of the fastest trains in the world being actually created in Japan. But guys, check out this video of how people actually get crammed in to the subway trains in Japan. Can you imagine being pushed into a train packed in like sardines? Those are the conductors, guys. They're just shoving the people in there just so they can get the doors closed. It couldn't be me. So how does Japan's high population density affect housing? You know, where people live and how they live. Japan's homes are smaller than U.S., and many of the Japanese homes do not even have separate bedrooms, and rooms are used for multiple purposes. So this photo right here is a picture of a high-rise apartment in Japan, and these are called capsule apartments, and these little boxes that look like Lego pieces are actually apartments. And as you can see down here in this photo, you actually see the inside of one of those capsule apartments. And they're roughly under often 250 square feet, which is a very small area. But this is how the way people live in Japan. How does Japan's high population density affect land use? So how they use the land, farming, building, things of that such. So there's not enough land for everybody's needs in Japan. So the Japanese have always built very tall buildings, And these buildings are actually built in such a way that they are able to handle the impact of earthquakes, which Japan gets quite often. And they even have underground parking lots. Thought this was pretty cool. Check out this video. So as the guy gets out, this car, he's going to actually go and pay for his parking, just like you would do in a parking lot here in the United States. But watch what happens to his car. You see that? I think that is so cool. And it's like a converter belt that like takes his car and pushes it into its space. And he comes and retrieves it later when he's ready to go. So cool. Great way to utilize space when you don't have a lot of it. So how does Japan's high population density affect the environment and people's health? So in Japan, people have always worn masks to avoid making others ill. I mean, you think at right now that, you know, we are being asked by our government and health officials to wear masks as we are battling this illness that's affecting our not only our country, but our world so devastatingly. But in Japan, they've always been wearing masks, and they've actually made them into fashion statements. You can see here, young people have actually created masks, and you see that one over there made, looks like a little monkey face or something. I don't know. It's kind of interesting. Japan also has very strict laws to help decrease waste and pollution. People recycle a lot in Japan. There are recycling bins everywhere, and they have recycling bins labeled for all kinds of items. And we think about here in our country, I usually only see one or two different types of recycling bins, but in Japan, they have recycling bins for everything you can imagine. And Japan has been actually ranked as one of the cleanest countries in the world. If you go to visit Japan, you are not going to see a lot of trash on the street. People take pride in their country, and so they make sure that things are picked up and that there are no trash on the ground. So this ends my latest production, Japan's population density. Hope you guys are doing okay. See you later.